Hello, welcome to another SwiftUI Basics tutorial. In this quick video, I'll show you how to display images and icons in your Xcode project. And I'll also show you some tips and tricks for customizing them as well. Let's dive in. So first, we're gonna start with a basic usage example. Now, where would you usually get your images? So I would say one of two different ways. So one would be maybe you wanna display a photo of some sort. So here I've gone to pexels.com to grab some royalty-free images for our demo. Alternatively, you might have an app design in Figma or another graphics tool. And usually in these tools that are meant for designing apps and user interfaces, you've got an exporting option. So for example, if I wanted to export this little button right here, if I scroll all the way to the bottom right inside Figma, I can export this in several different file formats, PNG, JPEG, SVG, PDF. All of these file formats would work inside Xcode. So just go ahead and export it. If you are grabbing an image for display, chances are it'll be PNG, JPEG. Go ahead, download that, and inside your Xcode project, you're gonna add it to your assets folder. So I've downloaded that image. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in there. And that's what this photo looks like. Now inside Xcode, before you display this photo, you have the opportunity to rename it. It gets added to your asset library as the file name, but if you wanted to, you could rename it here. So go ahead and do that first. I'm gonna leave mine as photo, and then we're gonna come back here and we're gonna display that photo in our user interface. So right now it's just got a text label. I'm gonna get rid of the text label and we're gonna use the SwiftUI image component. And the keyword to use here is image, followed by a pair of parentheses like that. Inside, you're gonna put a string, and that is a piece of text surrounded by quotation marks. And that string is going to be the image asset name. So if you remember, we added it as photo. See, it has to match here. If it doesn't match here, it's not gonna display anything. So as you can see right away, this gets shown. Now this doesn't quite look like this, right? The problem is, it gets displayed at whatever resolution and size that your photo is originally. That's why it's so large. What we have to do, if you want to shrink it down, is you have to tell SwiftUI this photo should be able to be resized. And you can do that just by adding the resizable modifier to your image component. And just like that, you can see that now it's shrunken down. However, you do notice that the photo doesn't quite reach the top and the bottom, right? Why are there white areas here? Well, that's the safe area. That area is for displaying the date and the time and stuff. And down here, you have that little bar that you can drag up among other things. So if you want to have your image display as a background and go beyond the safe area, you have to add another modifier called ignore safe area. And then you can have your image go full screen across your app. Now, the other problem that I see here is that it's stretched. You can see here that it's not quite so long. It's very long in our app. So we have to add another modifier to preserve the aspect ratio. And the aspect ratio just means the height to width ratio. We want to maintain that when the image gets resized. So you add another one called aspect ratio content mode. And there are two different options here. You can select fill, which will fill all available space while maintaining the correct height and width ratio. So that's why here you can see that it's not stretched anymore. The problem with this approach is that you might get some cut off on either the top or the side, depending on which side's longer. So for us, it looks like the left and right sides are cut off. Now that might be okay for your app. If so, leave it as content mode fill. If you don't like that, alternatively, you could do content mode fit. And what this will do is it will make sure it fits the entire image and it will enlarge it to its max while still displaying the entire image with nothing cropped. You can see that the downside to that is that there's a lot of white space. So really, it depends what you need. But that is your basic usage example. That's how you display an image in a SwiftUI app. Next, we're going to talk about some customizations that you can do to this image. Oh, and one quick thing, if you want to download the sample code for this, we've got it all in a single handy Xcode project. In fact, it contains a sample code for all of the SwiftUI components so that you can learn from it or copy and paste the code into your own project. Just visit cwc.to/swiftui-kit. It's a free download. I'll leave it in the description below the video too. All right, now back to the tutorial. Now, in terms of customization, a lot of SwiftUI modifiers just work out of the box on the image. For example, if you wanted to display this image in a specific shape, you would use the clip shape modifier. And for example, we could display a profile photo in a circle just like that. Now, instead of a circle, you could also just put a rounded rectangle with a corner radius of 10, not corner size. I make that mistake a lot. And that would give you a rounded rectangle. Let's add some padding to that so that you can actually see it off the edges. And so now it's starting to look like a standard card. You can also add a shadow. So for example, that puts a default shadow at the top. If you want it at the bottom, you can add, you can say that, and that switches the Y coordinate of the shadow to point downwards. So you can see it's a little below the image now. And furthermore, let's say you wanted it to be semi-transparent. You could use an opacity right there. And let's say 0.5. So it's like half transparent, semi-transparent. All right, now let's talk about how would you display icons. And I don't know if you know, but SF symbols, this is a great way to use icons in iOS. So you can download this app and you can browse through the app for these different symbols. I've got one of the older versions installed, and let me just launch that so we can. So if I search for down, let's say we're going to take this one, and we're going to add a download button or something like that. You basically take the name of the symbol and you can display it in a SwiftUI image component. So I'm going to do that here inside Xcode. Let's put this inside a VStack first of all. And then in here, I'm just going to add a button where this is the code and the label is going to be an image. Now, in order to reference the SF symbol name, which was arrow.down, we have to use another image initializer called system name. And instead of passing in anything in the asset catalog, we would just put arrow down. So you can see there's an arrow right there. And then we're just going to put a text beside it that says download. And so that is our button. Let's make this a button style. Just a bordered prominent. There we go. Now, two last things before you go. Here's a playlist of all the videos where we're going to cover all of these SwiftUI components. And down here, you can grab that Xcode project that contains the sample code for all of these SwiftUI components. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.